I'm here at the home of Robert Garcia. In just a few minutes, they're going to have a victory party for Evgeny Gradovich, a Mexican-Russian who won a world title. So Robert, you were just in Connecticut, Evgeny Gradovich, your second champion this year.
Yeah.
Tell me about that. I mean, winning with Mikey was historical, your brother.
In a month and a half, we had two champions in a month and a half, right? January 19th to March 1st.
But you know what's crazy though, what people don't know is that you go to so many cards. You go from the smaller cards, you travel cross country, you come back the next day, you're at another card, you come back the next day.
Last weekend, we were, I was in Washington, D.C. Friday. Saturday, I was at
Hawaiian Gardens.
Hawaiian Gardens. And then Sunday, I was at meet and greet with Brandon. So that was pretty busy.
So tell me about the fight with the Evgeny Gradovich. You're over there. First of all, did you get a chance to meet 50 Cent?
Didn't. I wanted to. I thought after the fight, he'd come and congratulate us and, you know, spend some time with a new champion. Nowhere to be seen.
Well, you know, maybe it was a surprise for him.
Mm-hmm. It was. We were supposed to lose. We were the underdogs. Very few people thought we could pull it off. Especially with the 29-day notice.
But you know what? Evgeny was on a mission, and I don't care what you put in front of him, it wouldn't stop him. Mm-hmm. He just kept coming and kept coming. And you were quoting the movie Rocky in the corner.
Because Evgeny... Every day in the gym, he's training so hard and training so hard, sparring and doing mitts, and he says it on his own. He dies. You know, he says it himself.
Pumps himself up.
So I reminded him, look.
That's why you're a good trainer, Robert. You know how to, like, get into your fighters.
In the later rounds, towards the maybe 8, 9, 10, the last rounds. You know, at first, we got to try to, you know, keep to the game plan and try to do body shots or get me those uppercuts, stuff like that. But when it comes to... So the later rounds already, somebody like Evgeny, he doesn't need instructions anymore. We can't give him instructions. Because the fight's already ugly, the fight's already dirty, the fight's already...
The ref had a shirt in your color in the beginning, but end of the fight it was...
The ref is already being involved too much, so he's already taking points away. So the instructions are not really... will not really help, you know. We have to, most of it, pump him up, you know, like, give him that energy, give him that... That positive, you know, that mentality, you know, you're winning, let's go, we got to keep trying, the fight is close, we got to motivate him, we got to pump him up, and things like, you know, your newborn baby, your wife in Russia, you know, you haven't seen him.
Did he have any family come to the fight for him?
Not that I know. That's even tougher. Even tougher. And then 29-day notice, you know, we tell him that, you know, one thing that he also reminded me was does my picture go on the wall now? So, you know, those are little things that we got.
No, not a picture, a mural.
Your mural, yeah.
mural. Thank you.
So that's what we got to do with him. I brought up his kids, his baby, his wife. I brought up, you know, the mural. I brought up the movie. He dies. I had to.
Yeah.
You know, it sounds maybe not... You know, it's nothing to do with we're trying to kill him.
No.
And then, you know, and to know that in the dressing room he collapsed and they take him to the hospital stretcher. So, you know, kind of feel bad for saying that, but it's not that's what I want. You know, I remind him because that's what he would say in training just to motivate him.
Cecilio started it.
Mm-hmm, you know, so.
And you know what? I got to give a lot of credit to your team. C did a great job. Because
Marco
too, mm-hmm.
He did a great job here.
Very underrated trainer. People don't know how good of a trainer he is.
We have a good team, man. We have a good team. He's experienced. You know, I sent him all week because I couldn't be there. I have to stay with Brandon. So I send Mark over there. I got nothing to worry about. You know, I know he's going to be right there aware of the weigh-ins, the gloves.
Very reliable.
The rules, meeting, everything. I got nothing to worry about. I'm glad, you know, that I got Marcos in my team. Because and besides that, in the gym, you know, he's the one picking up the rush and bringing him to the gym, taking him home, and training him too. You know, it's not like I'm doing everything by myself. He did a great job with the rushing. You know, he was on him, and luckily, Marco just had his wife just had twins. So he's so they're home. So he's not working right now. He got some time off to spend with his wife and
maternity
the
leave.
They got twins. There you go, maternity leave. They got that, and you know we're glad to have Marcos in our team.
What can you say about Billy Dib? He showed a lot of heart. Very a lot of other fighters would have thrown in the towel 8th, 9th round, 10th round.
A lot of heart. Good game plan too. They had a really good game plan. It's just the Russian is just the Russian, you know. Just it's like Brandon, you know. You could have a good game plan against Brandon, it's not gonna work after a few rounds.
I like Billy Dib's skills. He looked very comfortable in the ring.
Good, very comfortable. But the
great
Russian
physical shape.
The Russian just was just stronger and dominated with his aggression and with his pressure, which was, you know, our plan anyways. But they had a good game plan.
Robert, did it sink in for Evgeny yet? He's going to be here in a minute. But do you think he understands yet what it means yet to be a world champion?
Yesterday when I dropped him off at the hotel, he still didn't have it. I told him he still hadn't had the feeling of a world champion. I asked him, you're a world champion. Do you feel like a world champion? Not yet. I have to rest first. He said he had to rest first. Yeah, but he's happy.
He's one of the nicest fighters, like individual, person, good manners that you'll ever meet in this sport.
It's gonna take a few days for him to really see it. You know, I'm a world champion. You know what I mean? When I became champion, same thing.
We have to let everybody in Russia know. That's a huge country. Man. That's an empire. And they love their fighters, Robert.
I'm not sure, but there's three plus Russia. I think there's only four Russian champions right now.
And he's one of them.
He's the fourth. Yeah.
And he did it as the Mexican Russian.
The Mexican Russian. What sort of do you want, eh?
A Coke? Thanks. So there you have it, boxer trainer Robert Garcia with another champion this year, a second champion in just about 2 months. For EsNews.com and Malisic Back reporting. Take a step back.